Alright, so this is my assassin, and apparently when I tried to move my elementalist, I did rush my elementalist to level 20, and then I moved her to the Eyes of the North, and then I went back to the prophecy expansion. I noticed that when you make a character that outside of your original campaign, so for example, if my assassins, I'm taking the example of my assassin. So my assassin is a faction campaign. So if I go back to the prophecies campaign region, I won't be able to do the initial quests of the prophecies campaign. So if you guys remember, I'm not sure if you can remember or not, but apparently the if you make your character to be the prophecies in the prophecy campaign region as your initial character, you will have the access to the Breezearing Ascalon, as well as some of the missions and side quests initially for your prophecies character, but those missions might not be available for the other heroes from other campaigns that come to the prophecies. So yeah, I'm not sure which one is available and which one is not, because you know, I use my elementalist and I use her to come to the Nightfall campaign and also the prophecies campaign. And for the prophecy campaign, I arrived at the Lion's Arch. For the Nightfall campaign, I already spoke to Komia, and I skipped the initial quests that allows me to recruit Kos, and also the Faranur temple missions. I skip all of that, and I go straight to meet with Acolyte Sasuke and Acolyte Jin, and choose between the two. And I go straight to meet with Dunkoro, Meloni, and also Kos at the same time. So I have already access to those heroes without doing the initial recruitment quest for them. So yeah, I mean, like because of that, I don't really know which initial missions that I will be missed when I use my Devish to come to the faction campaign. So I might as well just, you know, record the video gameplay of my assassins, because originally I was planning, as you guys already noticed from my earlier videos, that originally I was planning to have my assassins and to have my the ritualist to rush through all that content and try to get as much skill as possible so that it can better assist my Devish in her future missions and quests. But because some of the missions that are not available for, might not be available for my Devish when she come to the faction and for the prophecy, so I might as well just recording this just for future references, you know, so I don't miss out all of the missions. So yeah, this is just what I have to say for the reason why I'm recording this. So yeah, let's get to it, shall we? Yeah, the assassin is very, very squishy. A lot of people told me about that, so yeah, I knew about this, but the thing is I didn't expect them to be this squishy. A few hit, and then you know, as you can see that my HP, my health points start dropping like nothing. So you know, I think that the if I want to make my assassin to be a better class, I think either I can go with a monk just to have some extra protection spell, because the monk has the protection spell in their skill, but I'm just not sure that is the assassin is and the monk build is going to be viable, or is it just gonna be, you know, half ass like some other build that I have witnesses. Because well, don't get me wrong, I play for quite a bit of time, but I'm nowhere near an expert yet. But I noticed that if you are making, say for example, if you make a ranger and then you put the mesmer to the ranger skill, I mean, like, still works from a couple of skills still support each other, but I don't think it's gonna be that great if you have the mesmer and the ranger, because the rangers is sort of like a mobility class from my experience. I did have a go at the ranger, by the way, and from what I can see from the ranger is that it has a mobility class and it deals quite a bit of AoE, and it can sort of pull the mobs from to your party. And also, yeah, it can play a lot of interrupts. Some of the skill in the ranger attribute spell has the interruption. So the mesmer is also condition damage and also interruption as well. So I'm just, you know, whenever I see a ranger and a mesmer, I just think that they don't work really well. That well, I mean, like, they still can support. In a sense that some skill do support each other, but I don't think it's a good combination for the ranger to go with the mesmer. And so back to this character, I'm just not sure if the combination between my assassins and the monk would be a good combination or not, because monk is more like a protection spell and also healing. And my assassin is sort of like a damage dealer, and most of the skill for my assassin is damage dealing anyway, and for protection, well, honestly, I haven't played the assassin for that long, so I don't know what sort of protection that I can unlock for my assassin, but this one is also good. I'm healed for like 65 health points whenever I shadow step to a mob that has more health point than me. And also the enchantment, this one, it can heal me for like what, about 5 health point regeneration, but the end effect, it will heal me for like 40 if I'm attacking. So I mean, like, it does have some sort have some protection spell. It's not really that bad, but you know, I haven't played assassin that well. I only play for like what, 19 minutes, so yeah, I can't really tell much about the class, but I will keep on experimenting and see what will be the best combination I can come up with for the assassin. But otherwise, I would love to have with the necromancer, because some of the skill set for the necromancer has a condition build, and I can sort of just like make my assassin to be a condition build assassin. I can just touch it, start healing, start stealing some of the health point from the mobs, and then, you know, shadow step, run away. So yeah, I think that the assassin and the necromancer can work out pretty well, because like some of the skill are can cover to each other, especially if the assassin is quite squishy. I can make my yeah, as you can see, not really, doesn't have a lot of protection, but yeah, because it's quite squishy from my experience of 19 minutes playing, I think I need to sacrifice a little bit of my DPS to cover for that. And I think that the blood attribute that can, you know, steal the health point from the morph, from the necromancer trait or attribute, if you prefer to use that term, is better. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah, this is where the tough decision coming in. I mean, like, I can change my secondary profession into something else, but the thing is that I don't have a lot of cash to spare for, you know, luxury changing profession from time to time. So, you know, when I decided to fix my profession classes for my main profession and for my secondary profession, then I'll start using that for life. So, actually, let's ask one of my guilty to see what. Well, I think this person is a he. Wait, only once. All right, there will. Okay. Hang on. Just let this guy finish and see what does he mean by only once. Wait, hang on, 500 gold for every secondary profession. Once you unlocked it, you can change it for free. Holy shit. Fuck, I didn't expect that. So basically, I can just make my devils to be, say, elementalist, and then I can change it back and forth between. All right. Fuck, I feel like a dumb person right now. Yeah, I do feel like an idiot. Oh shit, I didn't do my research properly.
Frick.
Yeah, I do feel like an idiot right now. All right, let me think. How about this? For my assassin, I will make him to be a necromancer in the secondary profession. For my ritualist, I will make her to be a ritualist and monk. And for my devils, I will cover the remaining classes like warrior and also paragon, and as well as the bloody ranger. Because now that I'm too far ahead with my elementalist, and I'm too far ahead with my other classes, I might as well just, you know, follow through with it, because there's no point, you know, just to like scrap my elementalist and all the shit. So we'll continue as planned, but this one will give me a little bit of advantage, I would say, now that I know that I don't necessarily have to play my other tools to be first about the secondary profession and what I have to do in order to obtain the skills. I can just, you know, rock with my devilish to be a secondary profession class to be, say, for example, a paragon. So I don't have to actually play a paragon to get her to have the skill for the paragon. I can just, like, you know, it's gonna cost me quite a bit of money, sure, but it will save me a lot of time and times, you know, I would value to between the times and the money. I think that I would just, you know, go with the time, because it's more efficient to just, you know, pay off, like, what, 4k, actually 500 gold for every secondary profession. So I'll pay for the paragon, I'll pay for the ranger for my devish, and then just capture the skill from you know, whatever. That will save me a lot of time, so I don't have to play the paragon again. So yeah, sorry about that. I feel like a fucking idiot right now. I didn't do the proper research. Fuck me. Alright, what's done is done. I can't go back and change it, so might as well just push forward. Yeah, the reason why I'm going for the necromancer first is because the monk skills in my other heroes is already covered for the majority of what I do anyway, except for some elite skill that I don't have it unlocked. But for the elite skill for the monk, I think I can rush through with the content of my for my ritualist, and so, you know, that's the only thing that I need for my monk anyway. But for the necromancer, I do need a lot of, and I mean a lot and a lot of other skills, so I'm gonna go ahead with this. Cause the aura of the Lich is from the prophecy expansion, not in the Nightfall or in the faction campaign. And I think that you can sort of get it in the bloody Eyes of the North as well, but I'm not too sure. I have to double check that. But anyway, this will give me a lot of access to my other professions, so that I can better adjust myself. Other skills for the necromancer, so I can better adjust my heroes, because my heroes for the necromancer, they don't have a lot of bloody minion bombers build, and I sort of kind of need that for my missions. So yeah, we're just gonna have to go with it for now. Yeah, this one it says requires 9 dagger mastery, but I only have like what? 6. No, I mean 5. So I'm just not sure if can I still use it. So let's just test this one out with this one right here. Okay, change it back to this one and see how it goes. If it doesn't work, then I'll just stick with the initial dagger for the time being until my mastery is high enough for me to use that one. Wait, so that was like what, 3 to 4? Try it again. Okay, so that's 22. Time for this. Yeah, I'm not doing that much of the damage at all. Wait, actually I do. Alright, sweet. I'll get rid of this. Cool. Yeah, this skill setup is not really a good idea. But again, I only have limited amount of skill anyway, so yeah, I'll try to... Wait. Where is my... Oh yeah, I don't have the fully unlocked for my Necromancer as my secondary profession, so still okay. Because I was just wondering, where the hell is my Minion Bomber skill?
Mm-hmm.